Hello and welcome. I'm your host Aditi Singh and you're watching My India. The 21st ASEAN India Summit marked a significant milestone in India's Act East policy, celebrating a decade of strengthened ties with ASEAN nations. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's commitment to enhancing this partnership was highlighted by a new 10-point plan focused on connectivity and resilience. The summit emphasized collaboration in science and technology, reinforcing the vital role of India-ASEAN relations in shaping the future of the region and navigating challenges in the emerging Asian century.
India's Act East policy aims to strengthen ties with the Asia-Pacific region. Initially an economic initiative, it has expanded to encompass political, strategic, and cultural dimensions, fostering dialogue and cooperation. The 21st ASEAN India Summit, held recently in the Vientiane city of Laos, marked a decade of the Act East policy. Prime Minister Narendra Modi attended the summit for the 11th time, collaborating with ASEAN leaders to review the ASEAN-India Comprehensive Strategic Partnership and discuss future cooperation. In his address to the summit, Prime Minister Modi emphasized India's commitment to ASEAN unity and centrality, referring to the 21st century as the Asian century, and highlighting the importance of India-ASEAN relations in shaping Asia's future.
एशियन सेंचुरी भारत और आसियान देशों की सेंचुरी है आज जब विश्व के कई हिस्सों में संघर्ष और तनाव की स्थिति है तब भारत और आसियान की मित्रता समन्वय संवाद और सहयोग बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण है
To commemorate a decade of the Act East policy, Prime Minister Modi introduced several initiatives aimed at fostering people-to-people connections, including a youth summit and a startup festival. Additionally, during the 21st ASEAN India Summit, he unveiled a comprehensive 10-point plan designed to strengthen the ASEAN-India Comprehensive Partnership, with a particular emphasis on enhancing connectivity and resilience. The key elements of this plan include the ASEAN-India Women Scientist Conclave, supported by the ASEAN-India Science and Technology Development Fund. The plan also seeks collaboration in digital and cyber resilience through a regular ASEAN-India Cyber Policy Dialogue, alongside workshops focused on green hydrogen.
I think it is an appropriate proposal because India and ASEAN, our relations have improved a lot during the last 10 years or so, but there is scope for more improvement. Our trade is now about 130 billion two-way, but it can improve even more. And one of the proposals is for the women scientists to get together. That's good. And also it speaks of cyberspace.
The 21st ASEAN India Summit reviewed achievements and set future goals for the ASEAN India Comprehensive Strategic Partnership. The event provided an opportunity to strengthen ties across various sectors, positioning the partnership as a cornerstone of the region's future growth. Ultimately, the summit symbolizes a new chapter in the Act East policy, where strengthened ties and collaborative initiatives pave the way for a prosperous and resilient future for both India and ASEAN nations. India-ASEAN relations are crucial for economic growth, strategic stability, and cultural exchange. This partnership boosts trade, enhances regional security, and supports collaboration in technology and climate change. Strengthening ties aligns with the ASEAN outlook on the Indo-Pacific, enabling both regions to navigate 21st century challenges effectively.
India is home to a rich tapestry of tribal communities, each with its unique culture, language, and traditions. There are over 700 scheduled tribes recognized by the government of India, primarily concentrated in specific regions. Today, we take you to the western state of Gujarat, where many tribal communities reside. The government is actively working for their welfare and development.
The Sindhi community in Gujarat is a unique ethnic group with African ancestry, settled in the regions of Junagadh and Gir Somnath. Despite their rich cultural heritage, the Sindhi community has faced socioeconomic challenges in the past. In 2003, the Sindhis were officially recognized as a scheduled tribe in Gujarat, making them eligible for various government benefits such as scholarships, job reservations, and financial assistance. The government's targeted efforts to integrate the community into mainstream development reflect its commitment to inclusive growth.
लगभग गांव में 70% लोगों को आवास योजना का लाभ मिल चुका है और प्रधानमंत्री जीवन ज्योति बीमा योजना है उसके तहत भी लगभग 80% लोगों का बीमा भी हो चुका है प्रधानमंत्री सुरक्षा बीमा योजना है वो भी लगभग 19% लोगों का हो गया है आयुष्मान कार्ड वो भी लगभग अभी 100% लोगों के पास हो गया है यहाँ पे और उसके तहत कई सारे लोगों को लाभ मिल गया है
भाजपा सरकार या मोदी साहब है उन्होंने जो डायरेक्ट नज़र की हमारे ऊपर तो आज हमारे लड़के करीबन जो स्पोर्ट में ज़्यादा मेहनत नहीं करते थे आज उनकी वजह से हमारे लड़के कहीं भावनगर नड़िया दे सापुतारा है अलग अलग करके बहुत से यहाँ से कोड़ीनार है और खेल में अभी शायद ओलंपिक में हमारा नाम भी आएगा उतनी मेहनत से कर रहे हमको बहुत फायदा है अभी
सरकार के तरफ से मकान की सहाय भी मिलती है और बच्चे को पढ़ाई के लिए भी मिलती है और जो आगे जाने के लिए जो थोड़ा सा खर्चा करना पड़ता है तो वो भी सरकार देते हुए है पानी की तो कोई समस्या नहीं है बिजली की भी कोई समस्या नहीं है ये सरकार से हम लोग बहुत खुश है
Gujarat has launched numerous schemes for the benefit of tribal communities in the state. One standout program is the Van Bandhu Kalyan Yojana, welfare scheme for Friends of the Forest, which has become a cornerstone for the development of Gujarat's tribal populations. Launched in 2007, the scheme's 10-point program focuses on comprehensive tribal development through employment generation, quality education, and infrastructure development. Today, nearly 15% of the state's budget is allocated to its tribal districts, reflecting a robust commitment to uplift Gujarat's tribal population of approximately 9 million people. Thanks to these efforts, Gujarat's tribal literacy rate has risen to 62%, with improved access to housing, healthcare, and sustainable income sources. Institutions like the Ashram Shalas, run by the Bil Seva Mandal, have played a crucial role in making quality education accessible to tribal children, strongly supported by the government through scholarships and grants. These scholarships cover tuition fees, books, uniforms, and other essentials, offering a lifeline of hope and progress for the state's tribal communities.
Bil Seva Mandal aisi choti moti 60 sanstha chalate hain यहाँ जो बैठे हैं ऐसी 20 आश्रम शाला हम चलाते हैं और करीब 15,000 से ज़्यादा बच्चे हमारे स्कूलों में रहते हैं और पढ़ते हैं बिल सेवा मंडल की ये संस्थाओं की वजह से राजस्थान एमपी और ये बॉर्डर के एरिया में जो शिक्षा का दर है वो शिक्षा का दर इसलिए बढ़ा है कि ये संस्था का यहाँ रहने का और खाने पीने का और पढ़ने का दोनों की सुविधा मिलती है जो गरीब माँ बाप के बच्चे हैं जो खेत मजदूरी करते हैं जिनका कोई यहाँ मिलता नहीं है और बाहर मजदूरी जाते हैं उनके बच्चे यहाँ रहते हैं पढ़ते हैं
The government's efforts have also empowered tribal women. In 2019, a group of 15 women from the Tadvi tribal community were given the opportunity to run a cafe at the Arogya Van in Kavidia. Their group, Jay and Gayatri, received an initial grant of $12,000 to start their business. Each of these women now earns a monthly salary of 8,000 rupees, with the kitchen serving traditional Gujarati dishes. The proceeds from their sales are deposited into the group's collective account, helping them sustain their livelihoods. They proudly boast of serving esteemed visitors, including former Indian President Ram Nath Kovind, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and even the co-founder of Microsoft, Bill Gates.
जो हम आदिवासी महिला है वो घर में से बाहर नहीं निकलती थी कभी अभी जो मोदी साहब आए वो रे सब प्लान किया टेंशन बड़ा सब बड़ा दिया तो हमका भी परिवर्तन हुआ और हमको भी अच्छा लगता है वो कैफे चलाते हैं सब महिला साथ जुल मिलकर हम 5-6 साल से काम कर रही है और हमारे बच्चे की पढ़ाई में खेत काम में सब वो पैसा मिलता है ये हम उपयोग में लगाते हैं
The tribal communities of India play a crucial role in the nation's cultural diversity, showcasing rich traditions, languages, and practices. Preserving their unique heritage is essential for maintaining this diversity. At the same time, promoting sustainable development through education, healthcare, and economic opportunities ensures their empowerment, enabling them to thrive while safeguarding their cultural identity for future generations.
And now, let's take you to the 217th annual Urs of Hazrat Qutubuddin Risaldar Shah Baba, a historic event that holds deep spiritual significance and embodies the essence of communal harmony. Now, this centuries-old tradition brings together people of different faiths, showcasing unity and brotherhood in a vibrant and peaceful way. Take a look.
The capital city of Jharkhand, Ranchi, offers a perfect combination of natural beauty and cultural richness. And this beautiful city is best known for revered Sufi saint Hazrat Qutubuddin Risaldar Shah Baba. His holy shrine spreads peace and unites people from different communities. The shrine is a symbol of communal harmony where people from different faiths come together to seek blessings and solace.
यहाँ पे हिंदू और मुसलमान और इवन किसी भी अकीदा के बल्कि यहाँ क्रिश्चियन भी बहुत अच्छी आबादी में हैं और यहाँ आते हैं और इस जगह पे किसी के साथ कोई भेदभाव नहीं है यहाँ पे एक ही धर्म बचता है वो सिर्फ इंसानियत का है यहाँ ना कोई हिंदू है ना कोई मुसलमान है इस जगह पे आने के बाद कांग्रेस पार्टी के भारतीय जनता पार्टी के कम्युनिस्ट के और बाहर में जो भी राजनीति करे लेकिन इस हुदूद में इस कैंपस में आने के बाद वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ इंसान रह जाता है और आपसी सद्भाव का संदेश देता है
Each year, thousands of devotees from various backgrounds gather at this holy shrine to seek blessings and solace. During your celebrations, the air is filled with soulful Qawwali music that captivates the audience with its heartfelt devotional songs.
ये बाबा रिसालदार का मजार है और वर्षों से मैं जब पॉलिटिक्स में नहीं थी मैं एक साहित्यकार थी और सामाजिक कार्यों में रहती थी उस समय से हम यहाँ आते हैं माथा टेकने के लिए और बाबा पर सभी जाति धर्म के लोग भरोसा माने विश्वास करते हैं और आते हैं आप यहाँ अगर सुबह से शाम तक रहेंगे तो देखेंगे कि ऐसा कोई जाति धर्म का व्यक्ति नहीं है जो नहीं आता होगा तो ये रांची में ये सांप्रदायिक सौहार्द का ये अद्भुत नमूना देखने को मिलता है
The shrine of Hazrat Qutubuddin Risaldar Shah Baba symbolizes communal harmony and spiritual unity. His teachings promote love, peace and coexistence, inspiring people of all ages. This revered Sufi saint's legacy unites diverse communities, fostering understanding and unity.
Now let's delve into World in Focus, featuring the latest global developments and events shaping our world.
Britain's King Charles and Queen Camilla were treated to a showcase of Samoan traditional culture, arts and craft on October 24, on their first full day in the Pacific Island nation. Traditional tattooing, dances and weaving were on display for the royal couple. Charles was on a three-day visit to Samoa ahead of the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, which is being held in the island nation. The British monarch is the symbolic head of the Commonwealth. Leaders and officials from the Commonwealth countries are expected to make a declaration on protecting the ocean, with climate change a key topic for discussion.
to Ladakh, North India's top spot for adventure enthusiasts. The capital Leh and its surroundings offer thrilling activities like trekking, mountaineering, river rafting and biking. With options catering to all ages, Ladakh is especially popular among the youth, providing endless opportunities for exploration and excitement. From scaling Himalayan peaks to bungee jumping, Ladakh is a must visit for thrill seekers.
Bikers in Ladakh ride through a paradise of rugged terrain and breathtaking views. From the thrill of sharp mountain curves to the freedom of vast open roads, every turn offers a new adventure. Against the backdrop of towering peaks and endless skies, Ladakh is a biker's dream come true.
यहाँ पे bikers के लिए का terrain इतना अच्छा है, roads इतने अच्छे, plus इससे भी plus एक ये चीज़ है, यहाँ जितने भी अपने world के highest motorable roads हैं, वो Ladakh में है। तो पहले आज से 3-4 साल पहले ये होते थे कि खरदुंगला highest motorable road थे। तो अभी अब जाके तो अभी तो इससे भी जाके अब अभी जो present है उमिंगला, which is the highest motorable road in the world, और आने वाले time में इससे भी और पास ऊपर height के और भी आने वाले। तो एक ये सारे ऐसा bikers lover लोगों का एक dream होता है कि मुझे world के highest road पे ride करना है।
The best time for biking in Ladakh is from April to October, when the roads are open and the weather is pleasant, with daytime temperatures between 15 and 25 degrees Celsius, while nights in higher altitude areas can drop to zero. Bikers typically choose sturdy bikes for rugged terrain and high altitudes.
बाइक का एक्सपीरियंस कार के एक्सपीरियंस से बहुत ही डिफरेंट है। ज़्यादातर गर्ल्स अवॉइड करती है बाय बाइक आना, क्योंकि वॉशरूम वगैरह की दिक्कत हो जाती है रास्ते में, क्योंकि 350 किलोमीटर ऐसा था जहाँ पर कुछ भी नहीं था, ऑफ रोडिंग भी थी वहाँ पर, मतलब लिटरली नो रेस्टोरेंट नथिंग, कोई भी रेस्ट करने के लिए कोई भी जगह नहीं थी। बट मेरा तो एक्सपीरियंस बहुत अच्छा था और हर लड़की को आना चाहिए मेरे हिसाब से तो, क्योंकि बहुत ही अच्छे नज़ारे और बाइकिंग एक्सपीरियंस वॉज सो फैबुलस और बहुत ही बढ़िया रहा मेरे लिए।
Ladakh has much to offer for adventure. It is one of the world's highest bungee jumping platforms at around 11,000 feet, located just a few miles from the confluence of the Zanskar and Indus rivers on Zilling Road, with a height of about 190 feet.
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Ye Ladakh bungee jumping 2022 mai mein shuru hua tha yahan. Ye इसका जो हाइट है टोटल 190 फीट है, मींस कि 65 मीटर है सर। ये हाई एल्टीट्यूड में बंजी जंपिंग सबसे फास्ट है। अभी इतना अल्टीट्यूड पे वर्ल्ड में कहीं भी बंजी जंपिंग नहीं है सर।
फर्स्ट टाइम मैंने बंजी जंपिंग की है। मैं जनरली कोई ट्रिप्स में जाता हूँ तो कुछ ना कुछ एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट्स करता हूँ, बंजी जंपिंग पहली बार कर रहा था। एंड ये आपका वर्ल्ड का हाइएस्ट ऑल्टीट्यूड पे ये बंजी जंपिंग होता है, सो मैंने ये किया, मेरे को बहुत मज़ा आया, बहुत ज़्यादा मज़ा आया।
Visitors eagerly enjoy river rafting in Ladakh. While numerous options exist on the Indus River and its tributaries, the most popular routes are around the confluence, including Phi to Nimo, Upshi to Karu, and Phi to Cesspool. Instructors provide essential rafting information, and boats are transported to the starting point, ensuring strict safety protocols and special attire for participants.
सपने के जैसा लगा मुझे कि इसका मजा तो हम बातों में बयान नहीं कर सकते, हमें बहुत अच्छा लगा। और सभी आइए रिवर, जो भी रिवर का जो मज़ा लीजिए, और जो हमारा दो नदियाँ एक साथ मिल रहे हैं वो भी, जो पानी अलग अलग है वो भी देखने को बहुत ही मज़ा आता है। सो हम हर भारतवासी को यही कहेंगे, एक बार जरूर आइए और ये मज़ा भी लीजिए।
Tourists experience the magic of river rafting in Ladakh, where deep valleys, towering peaks, monasteries, and hillside villages paint a stunning backdrop. As you navigate the Indus and Zanskar rivers, often dubbed the Grand Canyon of the Himalayas, you'll immerse yourself in vibrant Ladakhi culture while savoring thrilling water adventures. This unforgettable journey promises memories that will last a lifetime.
India has launched several initiatives over the years to promote cleaner cities and improve urban sanitation. Today we take you to Visakhapatnam, popularly known as Vizag, in southern India, a city that has implemented numerous measures to rank among the country's cleanest. From restoring its stunning beaches to embracing community-driven sustainable practices, Visakhapatnam's journey is one of resilience, innovation, and hope.
Vizag, a coastal gem in southern India, renowned for its scenic beaches, has emerged as a beacon of sustainable urban development. The city has fought challenges of poor waste management and polluted shores with proactive measures taken by a local municipality and residents. Today, regular cleanliness drives, enhanced sanitation, and robust waste management have breathed new life into the city. The revitalization of its beaches, once choked with plastic, is a shining testament to this success, placing Vizag proudly among India's top five cleanest cities.
Visakhapatnam is a neat and clean city, and you can find the greenery everywhere. And GVMC has taken the effort and planted the trees, coconut trees, near the beaches. So the tourists are coming.
Clean city ke baare mein bolenge to top 10 mein aa rahi hai, clean cities ke liye. मोदी जी जो स्वच्छ भारत अभियान जो चलाया है वो बहुत अच्छा लगा है।
Visakhapatnam's sustainability success owes much to its proactive resident welfare association. These communities have embraced waste segregation, promoting the separation of wet and dry waste. They've also implemented rainwater harvesting, addressing water scarcity issues, and reduced plastic use by encouraging cloth bags. Their collective efforts have created cleaner, greener and more self-sufficient neighborhoods, serving as a model for sustainable living.
2016 में स्वच्छ भारत प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी दिया उसके बाद में उसी टाइम में जीवीएमसी ऑफिसर श्री हरिनारायण मिश्रा आईएएस ऑफिसर हमारा कॉलोनी को आया फर्स्ट शुरू में हम लोग इधर से वेटन ड्राई शुरू किया वो बहुत अच्छा रिजल्ट आया उसके बाद में पूरा सिटी आया उनका फायदा हमको GVMC बहुत एपिसेट करके हमारे एरिया में रोड एंड पार्क सब ऐसे अभी उसी टाइम से अभी तक हर एक कमिश्नर एंड जोनल का जोनल ऑफिसर सब लोग हमको मदद दे रहा
फॉर द सस्टेनेबल अर्बन एनवायरनमेंट द मेन एस्पेक्ट्स इन्वॉल्वड आर ग्रीनरी डेवलपमेंट कंट्रोलिंग द पोल्यूशन कंट्रोलिंग द प्लास्टिक यूसेज रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग एंड देन सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट So our colony is following almost in all these aspects for the last 15 to 20 years. Our asset is mainly in greenery development and rainwater harvest.
The Clean India mission focuses on waste management, public sanitation facilities, and behavioral change campaigns to promote cleanliness. Cities are ranked annually under the Swachh Sarvekshan survey, encouraging competition for the title of the cleanest city in India. The initiative has had a significant impact, with cities like Indore, Surat, and Vizag consistently leading the rankings and setting examples for sustainable urban cleanliness.
As Visakhapatnam leads the way, the vision of a cleaner India is within reach. With that, we wrap up today's episode of My India, but we will see you next week at the same time. Till then, goodbye and take care.